Welcome to the training course on the Zonoposter program. In this lesson, we will learn how to install the Zonoposter program and go through the initial setup of the program. To install the Zonoposter program, you need to be registered on the zonalab.com website. If you haven't done this before, let's go through the registration process. Go to the zonalab.com website and click on the user profile section. Click register and provide an email address to which you will have permanent access. Because if you lose access to your Zonoposter account, you will lose access to all your created Zonoposter projects. Enter a username, password, and solve the CAPTCHA. Next, you need to confirm your email address. After confirming your email address, you will be redirected to your account page. In this field, all available versions of the Zonopost program will be listed. It's empty here. So let's figure out how to get the Zonoposter program. Buy it or use the demo version. Go to the zonalab.com website and click on the Zonoposter section. Scroll all the way down. And here, only a monthly subscription of $37 is available, which includes all updates. That is, when you have an active subscription, you will be able to install all available updates. There is a small limitation. Installation on three machines and single-threaded operation on one machine. Let me explain the meaning of this limitation. When you install Zonoposter on your computer, two programs are installed. Zonoposter itself is necessary for running scripts, and Project Maker necessary for creating these scripts. So, you can install Zonoposter under your zonalab.com profile on an unlimited number of computers, but you can only run the Zonoposter on program on one machine at a time, and Project Maker on three. This is the only limitation. You can also install a demo version, which has a number of small limitations. Enter your email address and our name. A link to install the demo version will be sent to your specified email. It is worth noting a number of limitations in the demo version. Firstly, you will not be able to use proxies in it. Secondly, you will not be able to automatically solve CAPTCHAs, meaning you can only solve them manually without using any CAPTCHA solving services. And it will also operate in only one thread. You will not be able to use multi-threading, meaning you cannot run the script simultaneously in multiple browser tabs. And the most important limitation, the demo version is only valid for 14 days. After this period, you will have a freeze on the demo version for 16 days, and only after 16 days, you can use the demo version again for 14 days. These are the small restrictions. We begin the installation of the Zonoposter program. We specify the path and enter the data from our account. Two shortcuts have appeared on the desktop, Project Maker and Zonoposter. So, Zonoposter can only be run on one computer at a time, while Project Maker can be run on three computers simultaneously. That is, there is no strict limitation on installation of the computer of the Zonoposter program itself. There is only a limitation on simultaneous execution. We launch Project Maker, we click OK here, so that we can get acquainted. And let's go through the initial setup of the program. Let's move to the appearance, and I indicate what makes it valuable. And Classic 2. Also, let's go to the button menu and enable email processing to work with emails and the regular expression tester. Click OK. Let's go over the other tabs. We don't touch anything here. Here as well. In the debug menu, don't touch anything either. Here as well. In the instance, don't touch anything either. The next tab is CAPTCHA. This tab lists all not available services for solving CAPTCHA. Enter the secret key. If your balance is displayed, it means you've done everything correctly. and use the services for automatic CAPTCHA solving. There is a service called CAP Monster Cloud. When you register on the zonalab.com website and purchase a license for the poster, a profile is automatically created for you on CAP Monster Cloud and credited with $5, so you can solve CAPTCHAs, Joe, for free, initially. In this tab, you specify SMS services. For example, for registering accounts using a phone number. In this tab, you specify the keys for text translation services, services for content creation, as well as for interacting with Google Sheets. In this tab, you can specify a list of email addresses with which you will interact in the script. You don't touch the profile, the hotkeys as well. I haven't even gone into the plugins. In this tab, we can change a couple of parameters. We can uncheck the box, log a message about the successful completion of the project, so that our log doesn't get cluttered. The log is a list of notifications about the state of your script. That is, all notifications that you will specify in the script, as well as its errors, successful and unsuccessful executions, are output to the so-called log. I set the log entries to be saved for 48 hours, and I always set the maximum number of entries to the maximum, which is 999. To apply the settings, you close this window and restart Project Maker, which is what we will do now. We restarted Project Maker, and as you can see, the theme changed from light to dark. Now, let's create a new project and set up the areas for working with the script. Damn. We restarted Project Maker, and as you can see, the theme changed from light to dark. Let's click on New Project and set up the areas for working with the script. First, let's disable this red automatic recording button. Go to the Window tab and check the boxes: Element Tree, Element Properties, and Traffic. Let's move the traffic over here and click on Auto Hide. Now, when we want to open it, we just need to click on its icon. And to close it, click on any other area. Let's move the variables over here and also move the log here. And the browser, let's put it in the first place. Let's move the Element Tree tab to the left side so it doesn't cover the browser window. And click on Auto Hide. Now, when we need one of the menus, we just click on it. And if we no longer need it, we click on another area to close it. Need traffic? Clicked on the Traffic tab. It opened for us, performed certain actions, and clicked on another area to close it. Basically, that's all for us. In the next lesson, we will start creating our first script.